I know that a lot of people love RGB computer components. I think they're pretty cool. But I think the one thing that we can all agree is pretty useless would be an RGB hard drive. That's why I'm gonna make one. And if you're thinking about making this yourself, just don't try. It's extremely impractical, and I don't even know if it's going to work. I have my doubts, but we're going to try to make it work, because I think it'd be cool if it works. Although, honestly, if it does work, I'm probably never going to use it, because I picked a hard drive that was already kind of dying, honestly. It's very old, and I don't trust it at all, so I wouldn't really use it for anything important, just, you know, look pretty, whatever. But so right now what we're doing is we're taking out all the screws from the hard drive, taking it off the top, and then we're going to put the the actual part of the hard drive into a plastic bag. We're doing this to make sure that dust does not get inside the hard drive while I'm working on it. Now that we've removed the top, we can make some markings on a sheet of acrylic to show where I'm going to cut it out. I had a few design ideas that all turned out pretty bad in the beginning. Like, I originally just planned to cut a circle out of the top of the drive. That was quickly changed, because I realized that it was going to be quite tricky and it just didn't make a lot of sense. As you can see, I'm struggling at trying to draw a circle, and I don't know, not that great at it. So, but now we're taking the drive and we're gonna make an outline of it so we can put it on the sheet of acrylic in a to exactly follow the outline of the little top, I don't know what it's called, but the little plate on the top, right? I actually changed my design after I cut out the first piece, because it was okay. I've never tried actually cutting acrylic before, and I'm really bad at it, so cutting out such a complex form as this was really bad, and I don't think it would have looked great anyways, even if I had done a good job. So I eventually changed it and just did a square, which I think in the end was a better choice, and it looks nice and modern, in my opinion. So yeah, now cutting it out so that we can trace on the acrylic. I didn't actually record making or cutting out the design for the second bit, but I don't think that was necessary, since you'd see this. While it is a failure, it's something, I don't know. I actually had a disc from a even older hard drive that I just took apart for fun to see, you know, what the side of hard drive is like. You might say it was kind of a waste, but I mean, it doesn't really matter, right? But since I had the disc, I was able to trace exactly what the circle of, since the disc size stay the same for the drives, I was able to exactly trace out how big I needed the window to be. I initially tried to make it larger because I wanted to cover up the edges on the inside of the cutout, but then I realized that it wouldn't fit on top and it would just look weird. So I made the hole on the inside a little bit smaller. Thank you. I think my original reason for this design was to make sure that there was a space, like, I didn't have to make cutouts for all the screws, because that was pretty complex, and I guess in the end, I did make cutouts for the screws, and it was pretty complex, but yeah. So, this is actually the final design for how I'm going to cut out the actual top plate of the hard drive. Just tracing a line along about the top half of that little, like, protrusion on the drive. I was originally going to cut it off here, but then I decided to go that I could go a little lower, and it would because it would probably cut off some of the actual disc and make it look not as good. So now, yeah, I don't have much footage of cutting it out, but yeah, so this was me trying to cut out the original bit, which did kind of fail. And then here's cutting out the actual bit of hard drive, which I bought 5 bits, and I broke them all trying to cut it out. It was a pretty strenuous process. But anyways, here are all the pieces cut out. I took these little screws, and I stuck them up through the holes to make sure that the holes were aligned when I glued it together. Because otherwise, I wouldn't be able to put the screwdriver through and screw down the plate onto the top, which would have been pretty bad. So yeah, now I'm removing the... Now, I'm going to remove the layers, yes, removing layers and putting some super glue, or crazy glue, in between the layers and then pushing down on it. Which, it looks really ugly, but I'm going to paint over the plastic anyways, so it obviously doesn't matter. So yeah, now it's all dried, and I forgot to run the cable through, so now I have to cut off the cable and resolder a new connection on, which was just added more time to the project, which I didn't really want to do, but I did it anyways. Yeah, cut it off, and now it can fit it through the hole. So yeah, now I'm painting it, and I'm really bad at painting, spray painting. I don't know why, I just, like, I feel like I can use a paintbrush pretty well, and make a pretty nice, like, painting, but I can't paint things with a spray can. In the end, it came out really bad, so I just took some sandpaper, I was gonna, like, sand it off and retry it, but it ended up giving it a bit of a brushed finish, which I ended up really liking in the moment, I guess. Looking at it now, it's not so great, but it's better than nothing. Anyways. Also, yeah, so I'm adding just a little bit of glue there to make the surface more even when I put down the strip. Also, the paint job on the window turned out absolutely atrocious. And once I put the RGB strip in and saw it working, the window just looked terrible, but it looked great without the window. So I cut a new window with a much thinner bezels, and it turned out much better in my opinion. So yeah, now we're putting the wire through the hole and going to glue the strip to the interior of the thing. Yeah, we have now glued it on, and we're going to solder on. Oh, what are we doing? I think we're actually going to put we're going to put the screws into here. I first originally tried to do the same method as I did before, but then I realized I'd have to put screws in, like the actual screws in under it. So I ditched that idea and I tried to use my screwdriver bits to hold it together. I don't know. It was the best I could think of. I guess it works okay. I put all the screws in. I actually lost one screw, but I ended up finding it later and was able to wedge it in under the thing, which was actually, that was actually super nice. So yeah, I'm putting in the screwdriver bits so they, like, line up into the screw holes so I can glue it together without moving it around so that the holes don't line up. The holes were a little bit off, which made it a little bit harder to screw it in, but they were in line enough that it worked out okay in the end. So yeah, now we've soldered on the joint, which I didn't really know what to do to solder it on, so I just put a little bit of heat shrink around the connection. Yeah, so now we have the newly cut window. You can see her over there. It's very much, has much smaller bezels, and now we're gonna put some window film on to the underside of the window. So basically, when we turn it on, it'll create an infinity mirror effect because the window film is like semi-transparent. So wherever the light, if the light is brighter behind it, you'll be able to see through it, but if the light is brighter in front of it, you won't be able to see through it, and it'll reflect. So it'll create an infinity mirror effect under the thing because the drive platters are very shiny. Now I'm cutting the window film out, of course. This camera angle is pretty bad. I actually, in the middle of this video, I ordered a tripod to try and get a better recording, but I actually think the beginning part turned out better. I actually have a better idea for positioning the tripod now, which will look much better than this and won't be half my monitor and keyboard, so hopefully it will provide for a better visual experience in the future. I'm trying to hold the thing down while I cut it out, and yeah, it's a little bit tricky because it always tries to curl up, and then you end up like trying to uncurl it, and you get fingerprints over it, and it's kind of annoying. It's not the best to work with, but it's doable, and I think the effect in the end turns out looking pretty good. So now I'm tracing around it with a pen, which isn't working. So I get like a felt tip pen, which does end up working, and use that to trace it out so I can cut it. You can barely see it on the camera, but I mean, the line is very faint, but I can still see it good enough to cut it. Of course, like, it would have been much better if I had like a Sharpie, but I don't have a Sharpie. I mean, I have a silver Sharpie, but I don't think that would have worked very well. And a dry erase marker, like, which I used on the acrylic, would have just erased, so that would have been no good. But anyways, yeah. Now we've cut it out, I'm putting a little bit of crazy glue on the very outer edge of the window so that when I press down the window film on top of it, it doesn't spread out over the clear section, so we don't see that ugly dried crazy glue like how it was before in the body part. Like I don't know what to call it, like the other part of plastic that I cut out. Like, I don't want it to look like that, but because I'm not painting over this, because it's a window, of course. So yeah, now I'm applying it on, and I'm putting a sketchbook on top of it, just to make sure it's pressed down evenly, although I don't think it really mattered that much in the end. I also forgot to clean off the two parts, so there's a little bit of dust stuck in between, which is not great. I do end up cleaning the outer edges afterwards to make sure everything is looking nice. Yeah, so I'm just smoothing it out a little bit. It's not great. It's pretty bumpy, but it's on the underside, and it looks pretty nice, I think. As you can see, there's a little bit of extras on the edge, which I trimmed most of it off. So yeah, here I am cleaning off the window with rubbing alcohol just to make sure there's no dust on it, because again, dust could get in the hard drive if I put this on top of the hard drive. And because it's a window, I don't want it to be dusty, because then it won't look very good. Yeah, I'm using 7% isopropyl alcohol to clean this off. I know, like, for thermal paste, like cleaning off thermal paste, everyone tells you use 99% rubbing alcohol. But, like, there's really no difference if you use 70. I haven't observed any. It doesn't really do anything, honestly. So, shouldn't go out of your way to get 99% if you're just cleaning off some thermal paste. It's not much of a big deal. So it looks pretty shiny, and as you can see, it's semi-transparent, so you can kind of see the RGB strips down there, because they're very bright, like white. They're not like on, of course, but they reflect more of the light sunlight, because they're white. I probably didn't need to explain that. So yeah, now I'm putting it on, and I'm going to glue it down, so that it stays on and so that there's no air gaps, because if there's an air gap, then that means dust can get into the hard drive, and I still, if possible, want it to work. So yeah, I'm just rotating it around so it has the best orientation to cover up the holes, and then applying some hot glue. So yeah, now we are basically done with the project, and we are going to start screwing it back down to the hard drive, I think. That is next. So yeah, putting this down, making sure I'm just screwing it down, of course. Nothing really special to this. Just turning some screws into some screw holes. I don't really have anything to say. So yeah, now what I'm doing is I'm applying some electrical tape around the edges just to make sure that there are no air gaps in between, because there definitely were, because I tried to apply hot glue all the way around, but there were some screws getting in the way, and there's, of course, the little opening for the wires, and of course the tape isn't covering it perfectly either. I could have applied it more strategically, maybe made it cover it all the way, but I think it covers about 99% of all the air holes. And, I mean, I guess I didn't really think about it until now, but the screw holes are technically air holes. So that's not great, but hopefully it will still work. Okay, yeah, so we're gonna go test it right now. And you can see the RGB effect is working fine. Okay, it's working completely fine right now. And now we're gonna go into the BIOS and go to configuration, save drives, and both of my hard drives are here, including the RGB one. So it works. which is actually really cool. I was not expecting it to work. But anyways, yeah, here's the final project, some crappy B-roll. If you, I don't know. It's not great, but whatever. Anyway, speaking of quality, I know this episode, how did I say episode? This video was not very high quality at all. And even the project that I did is not very high quality. But in the future, I will do my best to improve and bring out lots of videos for you guys. So if you want to see that, if you want to see more creative content, please subscribe. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.